take a look past our innocence. Take a step back to yesterday. But when life would move slower, we would never grow up. All we knew that love was for when we're older. Anything could happen, secretly imagine. They could never tear us apart, too young to fall.
This is our story, that we could take back someday. Our lonely glory, that we could get back, they say.
Take a look past our innocence. Take a step back to yesterday. When life would move slower, we would never grow up. All we knew that love was for when we're older. Anything could happen, secretly imagine. They could never tear us apart, too young to fall.
This is our story, that we could take back someday. Our lonely glory, that we could get back, they say.
Jordan dyed his hair.
Falling on stage.
I will never forget sophomore class trip.
I will never forget senior camp.
I went to a heat game during sophomore year. I will never forget rainbow competitions. I'll never forget all the choir trips I've been on.
It's going, okay,
I will never forget Alyssa's 18th birthday party.
Yes! Oh,
never.
No.
Is that this year?
No, I'll never forget it either.
I'll never forget it.
Why?
I'll never forget Louis.
Because we're all like a family here.
And he broke the girl's window at senior camp.
I'll never forget the first day of school. I ripped my pants.
I'll never forget
the time that Madison swallowed a quarter.
Life.
I had to do number two.
What?
I was Moody.
No, definitely Aitza.
True.
You wait. That's everyone's always like bonding with her. Like, she knows more than I do.
To finish the yearbook today, or else we have to pay a huge fine. And Mr. Martinez would be mad at the teacher.
One time, I saw a polar bear on the
pool. Was when I told my teacher I lost my pants on the class.
What was the question again?
What's the key to success?
Hard work, determination, great banter with the lunch ladies.
Procrastination.
You need to have...
Don't go to school.
Wisdom.
I see myself being successful aerospace engineer.
Oh my.
Oh,
how old will I be in 10 years?
Death.
10 years?
28.
Well, that was good math.
Dead.
Not playing basketball.
Tried to tape this about 10 times and I cried 5 seconds in. So here we go. First of all, I hope you guys are having an amazing night. We worked super hard to make this extra special for you guys because you guys truly are a special group of kids. I wanted to take this opportunity to thank you guys for so many things. I know you guys thank me for different things all the time, but really I should be the one thanking you guys. I want to thank you first for dealing with my crazy elaborate ideas, and not only do you listen to them, but you help me pull them off and you execute them perfectly, even if it involves 10-hour long lip sync practices with me screaming at the top of my lungs. You guys are always there with a smile on your face, ready to work. You never disappoint me. I wanna also thank you guys for preparing me to be the best mom that I can be. Through our mentoring sessions, you've taught me how to talk to my kids. You've also loved on my kids, and I want to thank you so much for that. They have about 50 older brothers and sisters because they have you guys. You guys are always there for them. If I need a babysitter, I have 10 of you fighting over who wants to do it. I also want to thank you guys for teaching them so much, even if it is songs that they shouldn't know. Abby. I also want to thank you guys for loving me and caring about me, truly caring about me. I see it on a daily basis. When I have 10 things to pull off in one day, you guys are the ones I go to, and you're always there, having my back, ready to work with me, and I'm so grateful for that. When I think about next year and you guys not being here, I get sick to my stomach, and I get super sad. Okay, here we go. I'm not gonna cry. I get super sad thinking of you guys not here because I feel like you're all a piece of me. But I find comfort in the fact that you guys will be out there in college, achieving your dreams, showing the world what you got. And I'm so, so proud of you guys for that. I'm gonna miss you guys so much, so much. I can't even describe how much I'm gonna miss you guys. But I love you with all my heart. And I hope you guys know that I'll always be here for you. and you'll always have a special place in my heart.
Seniors, class of 2016, wow, you finally made it. I just want you guys to know how proud I am of you. I love you, and I miss you guys very much. I would do anything just to be there and see your faces, and I'm sure you guys look amazing, all dressed up, and man, especially to just be there your senior year to see you guys and experience it all with you. Very proud of you all. And I just wanted to remind you quickly about a key thing, and that's as you go on in this journey and go to explore, just remember your relationship with Jesus Christ, and that you are rooted in Him, deeply rooted, and that He would be the foundation, the center of all that you do. And there is where your true success is found. As I knew I was gonna be doing this short video for you guys, which I'm honored to do, I was in prayer and I was reading the word, and I wanna share with you something that Paul shared to Timothy. And it's found in 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 21, and it says this. It says, therefore, if anyone cleanses himself from what is dishonorable, he will be a vessel for honorable use, set apart as holy, useful to the master of the house, ready for every good work. And that's my prayer for you guys, that if there's anything in your life as you start on in this journey here, and if it's anything that is dishonorable to the Lord, that you would examine yourself, that you would turn away from it, cut it off, and that you would be vessels of honor. Because in that, it says here that you would be ready for every good work. And I know that right then and there is where your joy will be found. So I encourage you guys. I love you very much. And I hope you're ready for this world to take it on. I know the world is not ready for you guys. You're going to do great things. So be encouraged. God bless you all. Love you.
Once upon a younger year, when all our shadows disappeared, the animals inside came out to play. Went face to face with all our fears, learned our lessons through the tears, made memories we knew would never fade. One day my father, he told me, son, don't let it slip away. He took me in his arms, I heard him say, when you get older, your wild heart will live for younger days. Think of me if ever you're afraid. He said one day you'll leave this world behind, so live a life you will remember. My father told me when I was just a child, these are the nights to never die. My father told me, they can't put out, carve your name into those shining stars. He said go venture far beyond the shores, don't forsake this life of yours. I'll guide you home no matter where you are. One day my father, he told me, son, don't let it slip away. When I was just a kid, I heard him say, when you get older, your wild heart will live for younger days. Think of me if ever you're afraid. He said one day behind, so live a life you will remember. My father told me.